Hi everyone, my name is Amanda Augustine and I'm the career advice expert for Top Resume, the largest resume writing service in the world. Every week I answer your job search questions that are sent in. You can always go to topresume.com and click on career advice to submit your questions as well. But this week I'm going to do a little special edition for the holidays. I have a number of questions from some very well-known professionals out there and give them my two cents about how I can help them move their careers forward. This question comes from a gentleman named Rudolph. He says, I just started interviewing and I could use some tips. People used to call me names and it left me with some confidence issues. Can you help? Hi, Rudolph. You know what? Totally understand. Everybody's got some sort of insecurity, and when you're interviewing, you feel like you're put under the magnifying glass. So of course, all those insecurities tend to come out. However, of course, you know, employers say that one of the number one things they're looking for or assessing someone for when they get into an interview is their level of confidence. Think of interviewing, it's very similar to the dating scene. You want to come across as confident, but not arrogant. You want to come across as eager, but not needy. It's this fine line of how you want to demonstrate, you know, your confidence. So there are a few things I think you can do. First, when you're picking out your interview attire, make sure you're considering, you know, what's your power color? Word on the street is you're a big fan of red. So I would work a piece of that color into your outfit, either as an accent, the tie, the pocket square, your socks even. Something that's gonna make you feel confident. Also, and I always say this over and over and over again, be prepared. The more you practice speaking, the more you practice interviewing, the more likely you are going to feel confident about what you're saying. I recommend if you know anybody at the company who currently works there or previously worked there, reach out to them. Get a sense of how the interview process is going to go so you can prepare what you want to say and what you want to ask. That's going to help you come across confidently. And really take a second look at that job description. What are they asking for? If you've already made it past that initial phone screen, again, think about what was the recruiter interested in most? What did that person keep asking you about? That's obviously something important to the job. So if that's an area that you feel very confident in, because obviously you have the skill set to do the job, you want to think about how can you convey with confidence that you have those qualities. Remember, if they've already picked you for the interview, you already got past the biggest hurdle, which is that big fat black hole of that your resume normally falls into. So you're already past that. They've seen something on your resume that interests them. Remember, that's one of the biggest hurdles. Now you actually get to talk to somebody about your value and not worry about a piece of technology screening your resume. So always keep that in mind. Also, remember that interviewing is a two-way street. And I think this is really important because people get so nervous and they get so, you know, insecure. Remember that you're interviewing that company as much as they're interviewing you. I know it doesn't feel that way all the time, but you want that job to be a really great match for you. And so you need to ask questions that are going to help you better understand what are their values and what are they really looking at or looking for in this person, so that you can then position your, position your qualities as the right fit for their role, but also B, you can better understand, is this a place you really want to work? So remember, it is a two-way street, and something I always like to tell professionals when they're interviewing, remember, most people who are interviewing you are not expert interviewers. So you know what? Oftentimes, hiring managers, they're just as nervous about the interview situation as you are. So don't let that get in your way. Again, practice. Take a deep breath before you go in, and remember, you already got past the application screening process. They already are interested in you. Now this is your opportunity to show them how excited you are about the role and to learn more about it and how you can explain why it's the great position for you. Best of luck.